Welcome back to the OU Insider YouTube channel. Parker Thune along with Jesse Crittenden as we bring you another installment of Quick Slants, 10 to 15 minute videos that we do several times a week over the course of the spring football season, bringing you up to speed on everything that's going on behind the scenes on the practice field for Oklahoma as they get closer and closer to April 22nd and the spring game, as you then look ahead to the 2023 season and year two under the direction of Brent Venables as the head coach at the University of Oklahoma. And Jesse, as we've kind of had the chance to watch a couple practices now, hear from coaches, hear from players, it's becoming quite clear, and it was obvious to a certain extent even before the spring began, that we were going to be facing some pretty compelling position battles at Oklahoma on both sides of the ball. So I'll leave things very broad for you up front. Is there a particular position battle that you're really honing in on and really, really interested in as spring turns over to summer and in turn becomes fall?
Oh, yeah. I think the number one thing for me at the top is defensive end. I mean, that is the position battle that has really stood out to me. And I think a lot of people could have guessed that that's the way it was going to be heading into the spring. But after getting to watch a couple of practices, it's clear that there's real competition there. Obviously you have Reggie Grimes and Ethan Downs, who got the start there last year. They've been the guys that have been kind of getting first reps and individual drills to start. But obviously there's a long period of time between now and the end of spring and obviously summer and fall camp. But then you add some other guys in the room. I mean, we've talked about Rondale Bothroyd is a guy that he talked about, you know, maybe playing on the interior, but he is a defensive end from Wake Forest. He's been practicing primarily at defensive end during practices. Then you got guys like R. Mason Thomas and PJ Adebare, who I think has really impressed. I noted that yesterday in our observations from practice that Miguel Chavis has his eye on PJ Adebare already. He's a guy that's really stood out, and you can see it. It's not just hearing the coaching. You see him. You see him on the field, the way he moves, his size. I don't think he's going to be a guy that they're going to necessarily just automatically assume he's a year away. I think there's so much potential for him right away. And then we're talking about guys like Trace Ford. It's just that room has a ton of experience, a ton of young potential, and there's so many ways it could shake out. I mean, honestly, after yesterday, I think PJ Adebare has a real chance to make a big impact right away. So, Reggie Grimes, we talked to him yesterday. He said there's a lot of competition in that room. He said it was kind of a wake-up call with how much OU added during the offseason that, hey, I mean, his starting job is not safe. So either way, I think that's the position at top of mind for me.
Yeah, and Reggie Grimes, I think one of the things that stood out that he mentioned over the course of his brief meeting with the media was referring to R. Mason Thomas and PJ Adebare. He said, those two are impact dudes right now. And we knew that about R. Mason Thomas, but to hear that from one of PJ Adebare's peers, I think confirms the suspicions that a lot of us had that that's a guy that's going to find his way onto the field very quickly. And you said it, man, PJ appears to be Miguel Chavis's practice field pet. And who was that guy a year ago? Well, it was R. Mason Thomas. And you saw him find his way onto the field early and often for Oklahoma as a true freshman. I would be very surprised if Adebare doesn't do the same, just because there is nobody in that room with his sheer physical gifts. Now, there are guys that are more seasoned, there are guys that are more refined, but in terms of just physical ceiling and ability, there is nobody, not even R. Mason Thomas, whom I love, nobody among that defensive end group that has what PJ Adebare brings to the table. Now, that said, I think if you're buying short-term stock on a guy at defensive end for 2023, buy it up on R. Mason Thomas. If you're buying long-term stock 2-3 years down the road, PJ Adebare is going to be one of the most fearsome forces in all of college football off the edge. So agree with you in the sense that there is much to be decided at defensive end, but I think some solace that Sooner fans can take in that reality is that whoever wins that job, whoever emerges as the starter once the season opens and Arkansas State comes to town, that's not a job that's going to be won easily. You're going to have to hold off hard charges from not only some experienced guys, you think about Reggie Grimes, Rondale Bothroyd, Marcus Stripling, but also those newcomers. And PJ Adebare, I think, is a true freshman, probably tops on that list. Now, in the secondary, We got the chance to talk to Brandon Hall last night. He was very complimentary of the depth within his room. And Billy Bowman is going to be one of his starting safeties. There is absolutely no question about that. But you look at the other safety position, some would say, okay, that's Reggie Pearson's job to lose. Some would say, hey, I really like Robert Spears Jennings. Others will sit there and say, hey, watch out for Peyton Bowen, man. So opposite Billy Bowman, who do you like to start at that other safety spot?
That's a really good question. I think, you know, if I had to say right now, I do think it's Reggie Pearson. I think he's a guy that stepped on the practice field right away and made a pretty big impression on the rest of the team. He's kind of the guy that of everybody we've talked to in the secondary, Reggie Pearson's kind of the guy that they immediately point to right away as a guy that not only brings experience, size, speed, all those things, but I think he's a guy that this OU coaching staff really wanted through the transfer portal. I think he fits what they want to do in the secondary. Now, obviously, as we've seen, it could take some time to get adjusted to Brent Venables' defense, and Brandon Hall even talked about that yesterday, that the OU defense, it sounds obvious, but Brent Venables' scheme relies heavily on the safety position, not just defensive backs. They rely heavily on safeties to do a variety of different things. So I think there's a lot that's going to need to shake out. But I think if I had to guess, I think it's Reggie Pearson. I think they like what he brings there, especially with his experience. But it's hard to say. Who stood out to you maybe through the first couple of practices?
No, I agree with you. And I think just hearing so many different opinions of Reggie Pearson's game, not only from his coaches, but from his peers. And we talked to Robert Spears Jennings last night, for instance. Reggie Pearson is a guy where if you just take in what people have to say about him, I think it's pretty clear that that's not a guy that's going to stay off the field much in 2023. So barring injury, I think whether it is at Cheetah or whether it is at safety, you can expect to see a lot of the Texas Tech transfer. Now, he is a one-year rental, right? So come 2024, the entire cast of characters is going to have an opportunity to replace Reggie Pearson at that position. And Key Lawrence is another guy that I have eyes on because I'm not really sure what to make of his situation. Now, folks behind the scenes have been talking him up throughout the spring, but they were talking him up throughout the spring a year ago too. And the product that you saw from Key Lawrence on the football field once the fall of 2022 rolled around really did not live up to expectations. Didn't feel like it met the standard. So the jury's still out for me on Key Lawrence, but I am really, really high on Robert Spears Jennings. I do think Peyton Bowen is going to be too good to keep off the field in year one. Maybe he doesn't see the same snap count that I expect PJ Adebare to see, but he's going to find his way onto the field in some capacity. I do think for my money, though, your two chief safeties are Billy Bowman and Reggie Pearson. But, and this is the case across the board on the defensive side of the ball, there is so much more quality depth than there was a year ago. And you're going to be able to get quality snaps and rotational action from so many more guys at all three levels than you were getting a season ago when the Sooners' three starting linebackers all played north of 85% of the snaps over the course of the season. So really encouraged to see what the Sooners have done to bolster their depth in that regard. Now, you flip over to the offensive side of the ball. I think a battle that's wide open right now is who's going to fill Marvin Mims' shoes? Because your three starting wideouts last year, for the most part, were Marvin Mims, Jahlil Farouk, Drake Stoops. Two of those guys are back, and Farouk and Stoops, Marvin Mims is off to the NFL. And so you look at all of the various contributors, all the various names in the hat in that receiver room. Who do you think has the inside track right now, and who would you keep an eye on heading into the fall?
Yeah, I think it's there's a couple of names that have really stood out through the spring and hearing different guys talk. It's Andrell Anthony and DJ Graham. That is really who stood out. I think it was hard to say before the spring ball started exactly where DJ Graham kind of stood in the pecking order. But after hearing, even receivers in that room talk about the strides he's made, we got to hear DJ Graham talk yesterday, and he straight up, he said his heart just wasn't in playing on defense anymore. He had to get to wide receiver. You hear so many of his teammates talk about just how much of a natural wide receiver he looks like. And, there was one person that said, you can't even tell he ever played on defense. So, I think that's going to be a battle that's going to go. I don't think it's going to be decided at the end of spring ball. I think this is a battle that's going to be taken to fall camp before anything's decided. A lot of people have talked about how much they like Andrell Anthony, his speed, his deep play threat, obviously. Then you've got all the young guys that we've talked about before with Nick Anderson and Jaden Gibson, you know, guys like that, and not to mention the freshmen coming in. But I think Andrell Anthony and DJ Graham, I have my eye more on DJ Graham than I did before coming into spring ball.
Now, I will say, you talk about the freshman coming in. Jaquez Petaway is certainly a guy that I expect to be in the mix from the get-go when he gets to campus in June. And that may be one of those players, because there's always one every year, right? It was R. Mason Thomas last year. It was Danny Stutzman the year before that. Guy doesn't show up to campus till June, so we're not buzzing about him all spring because he's not there. But boom, all of a sudden, fall camp hits in August, and everybody's raving about this kid. That could very well be Jaquez Petaway this season for Oklahoma. For Jesse Crittenden, I'm Parker Thune. Thanks so much for tuning in for this installment of Quick Slants. Plenty more coverage coming your way the rest of the week. And as we get closer and closer to that April 22nd date, as the Sooners prepare for their second spring game under the direction of Brent Venables, hit subscribe, head to OUinsider.com for much more, and we'll see you next time.